Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. This is one of the subtopic in the overall Python Learning Series on the channel. So in this topic, I am planning to cover Python library Parameco. Because in the previous videos, we have seen how to initiate SSH using Parameco, get the output from the device, parse the output. But we haven't looked into Parameco in detail. And in this series, I am planning to cover Parameco in more depth. And this series is going to have a couple of more videos. So this is the first video in that. For example, in the previous videos we have seen, in the missing host key part, we were just adding auto add policy, but we were not looking into the other options to secure our SSH communication. So the topics what I'm planning to cover are using Parameco, how to update SSH host key policy for additional security while doing SSH to the devices. Then how to enable SSH key based authentication in Linux or Cisco devices, which is more reliable and secure than static username and password. Then difference between invoke shell and execute command methods, which one to use while you communicate with network devices. So we'll see those in detail in this series. So this series is going to have a couple of more videos. So let's get started. Here you can see I have created a Python file, SSH host key policy, and I have another Ubuntu machine here. It is my secondary Ubuntu machine. So I'll be trying to SSH from this primary machine to secondary machine using Parameco. And later we'll see how to do it to a Cisco device. Both are going to have same logic, only command is going to vary for Cisco. So first we'll import Parameco. And then I'll define the host. The host name for this secondary Ubuntu is ubuntu2.test.lab, and username is user2 there. Then password. Either we can hard code the password or we can ask user to give the password. First we'll see the input method. Input, and there we'll get a prompt for password. Enter password. Okay, let's try running the script. So you can see here it is prompting for password. I'll give a password. Let me just give a colon also here. Now you can see here, but here the password is getting printed. So if you want to hide it, we can use getPass module. So what we'll do, we'll import that from getPass. Import getPass, and here we can give getPass. Now let's try running the script. This is the warning from the IDE what I'm using. So what it is saying is IDE cannot control echo of the terminal. So here if I give any password, my IDE will echo the password, but in real time if you run it from terminal. So I'll show that. Let me just save this file. Let me just try running this from here. See, if we can give any password, it won't print in the terminal. But if I try it from my IDE, it'll print the password. So it is a behavior of IDE, but actually getPass is hiding the password from terminal. Now if you want to use a default value, what we can do, for example, if username, if you want to ask the user to enter, I'll give input. enter username. I'll give what over here. Now what will happen is user will be prompted for a username, but if user doesn't give anything, it will take user to us the default value. Let's try running this script. So enter username, it is asking. It is asking for password also. If you want to verify that, so what we'll do, we'll do a print here. After user enters it, it should print the username which it has taken. I'll use a fstring. Fstring is formatted string. Here I'll give username is, and I'll give the variable, the above variable what I mentioned, the username. Let's try running it. Without giving anything, if I enter, you can see username is user2. But if I give any username, admin, so you can see it has taken that as a username. In that way, you can customize this. I'll delete this print statement. Now we have host, username and password. Now we'll move into Parameco. So let's go to the official site of Parameco. Here we'll see. So we'll use same method here. I'll call this as session equals Parameco dot SSH client. So this is an object now. Now we won't do anything for key management now, SSH key management. We'll just see how to connect to the device. So you can see here client.connect here. In my case it is session.connect. And inside that we'll see the details. So under connect, you need to give host name, port number, by default it is 22, username, password, everything. So in our case, let's try giving host name equals host, then username equals, in our case it is a username variable, then password is going to be this password. So after that, let's go and have a look into the document. So you can see here stdin out and std error. So if you use in our case session.exe command, it will create a tuple. Okay, you can see here once you do the exec command, you can see it returns three tuples, stdin, stdout and stderror. Instead of this, you can give any name in the variable part, and let's do that. Exec command, in our case we'll execute the command hostname. So let's try executing hostname here. You can see I should get Ubuntu OS 2. And here what it means, stdin means it'll add this command in the SSH channel, then stdout, the whatever output you get, it will be added, it will be in the stdout. And stderror, if you get any error, so that will come in stderror. Now we'll, if you want, you can add a delay time.sleep, will give 0.5 seconds delay. So we'll import time as well here. Then we'll try printing the output. Print stdout. So the whatever input you are giving using stdin, the output will be here, will be stored here, stdout. And if you are having any error, it will be stored here in the stderror. Now stdout dot read, and if it is a multiple line, it is better to decode the message. But in our case, even if we don't decode it, it is fine, it will come in bytes, but okay, we'll try to decode it. Then we'll close the session. Now let's try running the script. Okay, so here we have a correction. Here not client, we need to give session. Let's try running it. So it is asking for username. Username by default, it will take user 2. I'll give the password. So you can see here, Ubuntu 2 not found in known host. That means I am getting SSH exception, because during the SSH handshake, my server, SSH server, my secondary server is giving a key, and my client is not able to validate that. So the first workaround what we can do here, as per this documentation, you can see there is a method missing host key policy. We can add missing host key policy, and what we can do, we can do auto add policy. Once we do that, it'll automatically, any unknown host, it'll automatically add. First we'll try that. After defining the session, now session dot set missing host key policy. And here parameco dot auto add policy. Now let's try running the script. So you can see authentication failed. So let's verify the username once. So username is user1 here. So let me try giving the actual username. You can see here, I have received the output. Now if you want to format this output, what we can do is, we'll just create an if string here. Okay, let's try running it again. Can see here, I'm getting the message what I formatted here using if string. Now let's see how to add this as a trusted key. Now here, if you see my client machine, I'll give SSH keygen hyphen f the host name what I used, and I'll verify whether I have any key added here for this machine. You can see I don't have any key here, so let me try SSH to this machine. SSH user 1 at. Now you can see it is asking so whether to add this in the host list. So if I give yes and if I verify it here, you can see now I have this host entry. Because we don't have that host entry, we were using this method here, auto add policy. Now we will see how to handle that and make the communication from the client to server more secure and trusted. So in the next video I'll cover that, how to use different policies here, for example reject policy and other want policy. All these things we'll see in the next video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.